that looks serious.
Made headlines around the world recently when he said the devil was present in the Vatican.
You're talking about something very real, aren't you?
Certo. Realissima. Vi dico, se credete al Vangelo, credete all'esistenza del demonio.
Absolutely, very real.
As to the devil's presence in the Vatican, he says that's no surprise. He once had to perform an exorcism on another exorcist.
The first thing we need to do if we're going to find out if the devil is at the Vatican is take a tour underneath the Vatican. As we arrive underneath the Vatican, we see that it's laid out in a number of rooms marked by letters, as we could see in this aerial view map. Now, we will be exploring some of the rooms in this map. Let's start off by looking in room C here. As we look into the room, we see that this is a mausoleum of a Lucius Tullius Zethus. The Vatican goes on and explains that this room was used for offerings to the dead. We read, "View of the north wall and mosaic floor. In the corners of the mosaic floor there are 8 marble squares with circular holes through which offerings to the dead were poured during the funeral rites carried out in the burial chamber." So here we have a room where offerings are done to the dead. That's pretty common in Catholicism. Now if we look in the next room, room E, so here in this room they have a vase which has the image of a Medusa. So here underneath the Vatican we have a Medusa. Again, we ask ourselves the question, this is a vase, but yet it's kept underneath the Vatican. This could have easily been removed. If the Vatican was a holy church, you would think that they would have done this. You think underneath the Vatican they would have things that are sacred to Christ and not foreign gods, not idols and images of foreign gods. Now, as we move down further to room H, here we see that this is the mausoleum that is one of the largest and most luxurious mausoleums underneath the Vatican of St. Peter's Basilica. It says that it was built at the beginning of the second half of the second century during the reign of Emperor Marcus Aurelius and belonging to a freedman of the important Valeri family. And as we're in this mausoleum, we see that there's lots of idols from the old Roman Empire. We ask ourselves, why does Rome keep these idols down underneath St. Peter's Basilica?